Today we are going to be creating a prismatic glass material inside of Maya and Anil. This is going to be another quick video, so let me show you my scene. I just have one 3D model of a radio that I got from somewhere and one HDRI for the lighting purpose, and that's it. So as you can see, this is my scene. Let me turn this on, and I'm going to switch the test resolution to 50% for now, and I think this is looking good. So let's start off by first creating a new material, Anand, and standard surface. Alright, so here we have a default standard surface. I'm going to turn off my diffuse now, since we are creating a glass material. And the second thing is to turn off the opaque. Go to your object shape, Anand, and turn off the opaque. Perfect. Now go to your standard surface. I'm going to call this glass. Prismatic, and next thing is probably changing the overall material to a glass material. Now we have something like this. The next thing I'm going to do is change the overall color of specular. Now there are three things that are going to contribute to this shader. The first thing is the specular color, the second is the transmission color, and the third thing is scatter color. So by combining all these three things, we are going to create that prismatic look. So the first thing we are going to do, and this is totally random, like you can choose any color you want. So as you can see, I have this color setup where I have taken this purplish color, but you can also go for something like, I don't know, pink. And then I have transmission. Here I will choose something like cyan or something. All right. So now as you can see, we see something. Right. The next thing we have to do is create the scatter color, which will kind of decide the whole thickness of your glass. Like for example, if you're creating a thick milk or something, that's why you use the scatter color. So for this, I'm going to take a pretty dark color, something like orange or something, and increase the depth to 15%, maybe less, maybe like 12%. Okay, this is looking good. Now to create the overall scene, the first thing I'm going to do is make the roughness to around 0.5. We don't want that much of roughness. What you can also do is you can play around with a thin fill. You can put the value of 270 and the IR value to 1.4, which will just give you a kind of soap bubble thin film. Now I'm going to pause this. I'm going to go to my main camera, and here I will just kind of make a good scene. Just rotate this something like this. And I think this is looking good. Alright. So let's run our IPR and go to your main cam. Alright. And let's switch this to 100%. So now as you can see, we have a really nice prismatic glass material. The way to play around with this is definitely play around with the transmission color. You can also play around with coat. You can pretty much take something like this and add a little bit of coat to it, right? If that helps, not too much, but just giving the little bit of tinting. You can also play around with the whole specular color, maybe changing it to something like this, and then changing the overall color of your transmission to something like this. So you get a different kind of result. Definitely play around with your colors to get different kind of results. And that's it. So I hope you like this video. Enjoy creating your custom glass.